Welcome to my kitchen. My name is Gertrude Mungai and you're watching Connect, which airs every Thursday and Friday at 10 p.m. Tonight, it's a special episode. As usual, Connect aims to sort you out in every aspect of your life. We have spoken about juicing. You know I have been juicing. I did a detox, then juicing became my way of life. It's become my lifestyle. I juice on daily basis. Once in a while I would, but most of the time I would. And if I don't, I would crave for it because it's that good for me. And the last time I talked about juicing back to nature, I brought Kunga on site, on the show. And I promised you, we will go to the kitchen, Kunga and I, and cook or make juices for you. Here we are. Welcome back to Connect, Kunga.
Thank you very much. I'm happy to be back here to share with the Connect family and yourself a more of a demonstration. Last time when we sat down, it was more of a talking and we talked theoretically.
Okay, Kunga, you have to go easy. When you talk about demonstration, Connect show, it means something else. Anywho.
Well, we will get down and dirty with the veggies today.
Yes.
Okay.
So, Kunga is kind enough to have prepared all this, and every tray has a certain juice which is supposed to do something different for you. And once these other problems are resolved, your Mombasa Raha is back on point. You'll be going to Mombasa Raha first class. Kunga,
yes.
Take us through.
Well, you know, Ms. Gertrude, we talk about Back to Nature and the Back to Nature movement. There's nothing more phenomenal than Mother Nature. And this is a representation of Mother Nature and part of her glory. And Mother Nature has been here since the beginning of humanity. And it'll be here even when humans are not here anymore. So in that regards, we're excited to share a few combinations of putting Mother Nature together that can be able to deal with a number of different ailments that humans get a chance to deal with, dealing with these lifestyle diseases. And by the way, since we look at the body and the person as a holistic person, all right? So when you're talking about, I know what the theme of part of your show is, the Mombasa Raha, it doesn't happen in an isolated sense. Part of the intimacy that a man and a woman share fits within a holistic, you know, part of what it means to be a human being. So when we bring health and wellness, right, a man known more natural, holistic lifestyle approach to health and wellness, it is able to enhance every part of our particular lives. So with that, we're going to be able to delve into.
Yes, like I told you, what's good for your health is good for your Mombasa Raha.
I second that. Okay, so with that, let's go ahead and look at what we have laid out over here.
Which juice are we making first? This straight, that, or
yeah, what you want to see? You see so much different colors, right? And one of the beautiful things when you're engaging with Mother Nature, you can get very creative. There are infinite possibilities that you can put together different combinations. However, these certain combinations here are going to deal with certain, say, for instance, this is going to help to deal with blood sugar here, as we have some zucchini, we have some spinach, we have some apple, we have some cilantro,
which is dania,
coriander, etc. This deals with a lot of abdominal issues. Cabbage is wonderful for that. So things like ulcers and other abdominal issues that we have, this is what this particular recipe is going to engage in. And this particular recipe, I know a lot of people are interested in health and wellness, but there are some women that love it for vanity sake.
Of course.
So the skin, having beautiful skin is what this particular recipe is going to address. But we're going to start off with, I know, which is something that's one of your favorites.
Yes.
It's called the ginger zinger shot.
Yes.
So are you ready for a little buzz and sort of to get
I'm so ready to take a shot with my
That, we have four simple ingredients. What I'm going to ask you to do is I'm going to ask you to take one of those. And I am also going to grab one of the smaller knives. And yes, let's go ahead and peel this particular citrus fruits. As you see, one of the things we have here are, and I'm going to bring my element on this side, and I know you have your component over there.
Okay, like now, for the lime, the lemon, some people don't peel, they just cut it and squeeze it with the lemon, the citrus squeezer.
Yes. And
what's the difference?
Now, the difference is, now we are big advocates for organic farming.
Okay.
Now, if you did not get your produce in terms of from organic farmers, then there sometimes might be certain chemicals that are still left on the fruits and vegetables
due to spraying,
due to spraying, the fertilizers, pesticides, etc. Mm-hmm. So in this case, we're going to go ahead and peel, even though there are a lot of great things that are in the peels of these citrus fruits that are amazing. But
the white stuff.
For the white stuff, but all the way through. So you might have even known some cooking dishes where you can grate the skin of a particular, you know, orange.
Yeah,
or
they call it the lemon zest or the orange zest.
There you go. There you go. So now, if you bring that in, if you probably cut that into, you know, halves right there.
Into wedges or halves?
Half are okay. Okay. And so and if you don't mind bringing those over here.
Quartered.
So we have three main ingredients, and then what we do is add a particular spice to it. Now with that, I'm here peeling a little bit of the ginger, and we have the lemon there, and we have a piece of orange.
Okay.
And what this does, as you know, in our Back to Nature system, we recommend that people have this first thing sort of in the morning after you had your water as an sort of a kicker, something to jumpstart the morning.
And that's why we call it. So you need to have water first.
It's good to have water, because water, along with the citrus, sort of brings a more alkaline sort of adjustment to the body to start off the
day. Actually, many people are not into that habit of waking up. The first thing you take is water.
It's wonderful, because you're now in the morning breaking your fast. That's why they call it breakfast. You're breaking your fast after you've been fasting for about 8 hours of sleep. And we recommend it Back to Nature system that you get great sleep, get a chance to have a rest. It's very important for optimal health and wellness. So now, as you break your fast, it's wonderful to break it with just plain water or with a little lemon water. And then now what you can have an opportunity to do is come and get your ginger zinger in. So with that, this is going to be just a little bit loud, but it's just going to take a couple of minutes.
Okay, first of all, this is a juicer. Before you switch it on, this is a juicer. Okay, this is about juicing. It's not about smoothies, because many times people use blenders.
Correct.
So we're using a juicer, which is going to separate. The juice is going to come through the jug.
Correct. And the pulp comes out of this side.
Okay.
And that's a very important distinction. There is a difference between juicing and smoothies. And smoothies are great, but juicing is on another level, right? And by the way, people hear about juicing and they think juicing doesn't, since you're separating the pulp, the juicing doesn't have fiber in it. That's not true. And like I mentioned the last time I was on your show, there are two kinds of fibers. One is a soluble fiber, and the other is are insoluble fibers.
Okay.
The insoluble fibers is what the body cannot digest and absorb. It's what passes through the system. However, the soluble fiber is what the body can absorb. And so do not think because you're juicing that you cannot have an opportunity to get your necessary fiber. Plus so many other things that we'll talk about as we go today.
Okay.
So let's go ahead and jump right into our particular juice preparation here for today. And what I'm going to do, by the way, we always have lots of fun when you're getting with the juicing. Now I want you to come over because this is going to be very demonstrative. I want you to go ahead, take in a couple in there. Very good. Very good. So we put in now the orange. We put in now
lime.
The lime. Let's feed in the ginger. Once that's there, like that, just give it a second. We're going to turn it off. Wow, can you smell the aroma that's in the air, right?
I'm waiting for this to
cure. This is going to be awesome. So with that being said, let's just move this over to the side there. We're going to bring a couple of shot glasses.
Oh, mine is here already.
Oh, you're already prepared.
Oh, yeah.
All right. And what we will do is pour a ginger shot there. Pour a ginger shot there.
It looks
fantastic. However, it's not completely over. What we're going to do is just take a tad bit of cayenne pepper.
Cayenne masala ya kuwasha kama wewe watoka Mombasa. Pilipili.
There you go. Put a tad bit of cayenne pepper on there. Now, madam.
Okay, you don't
actually I prefer
mine is not too scary when they mix it up.
Okay, fantastic.
Okay, we're getting drunk. Oh, we're getting high on juice. Okay, it's good drunkenness. Okay, so.
Well, this is something that we will feel right away, immediately. So, bottoms up.
Okay, I'm up. I have woken up.
Now, what that starts to do,
oh my God, it starts to feel it going down my throat to everywhere.
It starts to aliven sort of our cells. It starts to open up our capillaries. Opens
I think my
up
cough is gone.
Our particular chest. Let's the nasal system kind of breathe better. Mother Nature is magnificent and beautiful in her day. So let's set this aside, Miss Gertrude, and to the Mombasa Raha family, and let's have an opportunity.
This is actually recommended when you're starting to juice. You have this fasting before your breakfast juice.
When you're doing, as a matter of fact, our entire every single recipe recommendation that Back to Nature has in regards to going on a 24-hour, 3-day, 7-day, 14-day, 21 or 28 day cleanse detox, we always start around 6 o'clock in the morning, or if you're up earlier, with what we call our ginger zinger, right? Because it opens up everything else to prepare for the day and prepare for the other juices that are gonna come, all right? So with that, let's go ahead and move this out of the way.
Okay.
And let's get to our next recipe.
Okay.
So with that, our next recipe we're gonna have lots of fun with, I'm gonna ask you to chop off the ends.
I'm Kunga's assistant today.
Very good. And as you will see, with this, everyone recognizes that these are carrots. These ones, whether you go and get them at the organic market, or if you're able to go right to the mama mboga and have a chance to pick up carrots.
So the difference is, if you're not sure it's organic, you can peel it.
We peel,
if
exactly.
If it's organic, just wash it up. Give it a good wash.
Correct.
I saw you scrubbing with a brush.
A pad, exactly. Okay. So we got a chance to scrub it well, and then we peeled it prior beforehand. Okay, so with that being said, I'm going to actually ask you, and so just to sort
enough?
Of demonstrate.
We're not chopping this?
No, because the juicer that we have will be able to handle it whole.
Mine has to, I mean, I'll show you mine. Because it's not as big as Kunga's. And you don't need to have a bigger one like Kunga's.
Yes.
I'm sure that was quite an investment.
So, as I go ahead and open up our bell pepper, which is a ho-ho, and as well as this apple, I'm going to ask you to peel the cucumbers.
Okay.
Now, this particular recipe is a recipe that primarily helps with the skin.
For glowy skin.
Exactly. Mm. Helps to bring, sort of rejuvenate a lot of the dermal topical aspects.
This recipe is going to be very popular with women.
Well, it's a wonderful recipe, relatively easy to make, and at the same time, quite delicious. And so the ingredients for this particular recipe are going to be primarily 4 carrots, a few pieces of ginger, which we'll go ahead and use here, a red bell pepper or ho-ho that you can get pretty much anywhere, and 2 cucumbers.
Yes.
And so we'll go ahead and open those up, and as we...
2 shoshobas.
There we go.
Okay, are we using the seeds from the bell pepper?
Not in this particular recipe. There are times in other different recipes that we will go ahead and use it. So I'm going to ask you to come on over and help me with this process once again.
Okay.
So
we have carrots.
Yes.
We have cucumbers.
Yes.
Ginger. We don't need to peel the ginger.
We washed it.
Okay.
And we got a chance to sort of take off a lot of the dirt from it. So we'll put it in just as it is.
All right.
Yes.
And then apples.
Yes.
Red bell peppers.
There we
go.
Can
we do yellow? Orange?
This
green?
One, yes. But the red is something unique. A lot of times people don't know the green bell peppers are actually not ripened yet.
Oh.
It's when they turn red and yellow that they're fully ripened.
Oh.
And so it's an interesting thing. But
it's not a type. There's one which is yellow. There's another one which is green.
No, they're actually all in a sense the same. It's just that this is actually a ripened.
Oh.
Changes color as it ripens.
Okay.
So actually when it's in this green state, it's not fully ripe just yet.
So before we actually juice, we're going to take a short break. When we come back, we continue juicing. And the first juice recipe we're going to do is carrots, cucumber, apples, ginger, and red ho-hos. And it's very good for the skin. Majority of us spend a lot of money on creams, night creams, day creams. I don't know if it's the midday cream. But then the fact is, we're looking for that beautiful, glowy skin. I promise you, if you go down this road, then you don't have to buy that expensive makeup. So your life is going to be cheaper and you don't spend a lot of time on the mirror, which means you have more time to go to Mombasa Raha First Class. Told you. Welcome to this very special episode of Connect. We are in the kitchen, juicing our way to a healthier life. I have always told you what is good for your health is good for your Mombasara. I almost said it's good for your Miss Victoria. Yes, and I'm sure you're thinking, what is Gertrude saying? There's a big cabbage, right? So don't worry, we'll talk about this. Sometimes it's okay to let Miss Victoria smell a little if you're going to be healthier a lot. You know, I've been telling women,
yes,
cabbage gives you a very strong smell,
yes,
around Miss Victoria, which,
yes,
is true. So we'll see how we can work around that.
Okay,
so we'll before we took a break, mm-hmm, Kunga and I were just about to make juice for the skin, for glowy skin,
absolutely
healthier skin,
yes,
richer skin. There's,
yes,
some people who are light or even dark, but they have pale skin. You can see, mm-hmm, the skin is not very healthy.
Yes.
All you need to do is mix up some carrots, cucumber, ginger, green apple, and red hoho,
yes,
and you're good to go.
Now, why is this combination so powerful?
Mm-hmm.
Ladies and gentlemen, and to the Mombasa Raha family out,
mm-hmm,
there, it contained in Mother Nature, you have, I would call, the most cutting edge, most advanced scientific, mm-hmm, technology for our human body.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Because inside and contained within these items,
mm-hmm,
you have what they call antioxidants.
Mm-hmm.
You have enzymes that are in there in tremendous amounts.
Mm-hmm.
You have minerals, you have vitamins, you have chlorophyll in a lot of the greens. And when you bring all of this in,
mm-hmm,
what it does is it starts to almost work like termites,
mm-hmm,
eating away at the toxicity, at the negative things, and getting a chance to rejuvenate,
mm-hmm,
getting a chance to bring all your organs back to life. And with that, that's what manifests in the skin, because the skin is the largest organ
in your
on
body.
The body.
Yes.
Right?
Yes,
and so a lot of times when you see the skin problem, what that is the body using the largest organ to sort of detoxify, and,
mm-hmm,
that manifests in the skin.
Mm-hmm.
But when you bring in the nutrients,
mm-hmm,
what Mother Nature has to offer in such a powerful way,
mm-hmm,
it allows for that particular detoxification process,
mm-hmm,
to, in a sense, be expedited, to be, you know, becomes a lot more powerful.
Imagine,
so with that,
you don't need drugs. You just need carrots from Mama Mboga, cucumber, ginger, apple, and red hoho.
Mm-hmm.
Imagine. You don't need to buy expensive creams and use some expensive medication.
Yes, and then on top of that, you have water, lemon water, things,
mm-hmm,
like coconut water, the madafu,
mm-hmm,
herbal teas, good sleep, a little bit of exercise, you know, getting a chance
and
to
perspire. And a lot of Mombasara.
So
don't forget to say a lot of Mombasara. You have to say it to Mombasara fans.
You're saying it more than enough, Miss Gertrude. So, but we know what show we're on,
okay,
today, and we appreciate to be talking to the Mombasara family.
Mm-hmm.
So with that, let's go ahead and
Which
make
one
this
are we
particular.
In this order?
So with that, the beautiful thing when making juices,
mm-hmm,
you can be creative. What we like to do, so for instance, if we have something, most of these are high liquefied juice. So when we get there and we're doing the spinach, they don't produce as much juice.
Mm-hmm.
What we'll typically like to do is to alternate. But,
uh-huh,
because each one of these has a high liquid content,
mm-hmm,
we can go ahead and work through
other
each one of
ginger,
them. And yes, so that will,
okay,
probably go in between when we put the ho-ho, the apples, then the ginger, and we'll just go on down the line. That,
okay,
right? So I'll take the ho-hos, you take the apples,
mm-hmm,
I'll take the ginger, and then we'll just go one-on-one in that way.
Mm-hmm.
Since it's a pretty much of a white, very white mouth here,
mm-hmm,
go ahead, open that in. The pulp is coming out on this side,
mm-hmm, and the juice
and
on the other
juice
side
is coming on that side.
Mm.
And you can just smell the aromas. The aromas smell very beautiful,
mm-hmm, and the color is amazing already.
Here we go.
Okay.
Okay.
So, we
so let me take in the ginger.
Mm-hmm.
I'll put in the ginger. You don't need too much ginger per se.
Mm-hmm.
So one or two thumbs of ginger are good. Or even if you're going to put some garlic in some of the recipes we have, not too much, because sometimes they can overpower the juice.
Mm-hmm.
All right? So now, okay, cucumber, you can put it in your bowl.
Cucumber.
Okay?
Wow.
And then you see how much juice it starts to produce.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? All right, that in. And then you can pass me some of the carrots.
Okay.
And let's go ahead and begin to work on the carrots.
This is a strong juicer. I'll show you mine. It doesn't do this.
Yeah, it's
still
about 700 watts here.
Okay.
So the juices can come. You can have an introductory sort of juicer,
mm-hmm,
that you can get for even 1,000 shillings on OLX.
Mm-hmm.
One that doesn't even require electricity.
Okay.
Or a basic 400,
just...
yeah,
mm-hmm,
manual juicer. Or the next basic introductory juicer will be a 400 watt juicer. That's the one that you may be talking about.
Mm-hmm.
typically it'll run anywhere between 3,500 shillings to 5,000.
Okay,
shillings.
Just a minute before you remove the juice.
Yes.
Okay, I remember in the Back to Nature community, yes, somebody was asking, this looks like so much waste.
Yes.
What can you do with this?
Okay, well, first and foremost, let's say this. Mm. What's happening when we're juicing here, mm-hmm, is we're outsourcing part of what happens in our body. Because remember, mm, the body does not digest this fiber. Mm-hmm. This fiber moves through the system. Mm-hmm. So the way we are made, so you have a mouth and you have this, you hold your intestines, mm, you go into your stomach, and then it continues to develop. Mm-hmm. So what we're doing is the same thing that your juice is doing. Mm-hmm. So when you eat a carrot and you begin to chew, mm-hmm, what you're doing is you're trying to separate, mm-hmm, the liquids, mm-hmm, from the fiber, mm-hmm, because that is what the body absorbs. The body absorbs the liquids, mm-hmm, and the nutrients, the vitamins, mm-hmm, the enzymes that are in, because this is what the body is looking for, energy from the food. Mm-hmm. So your entire digestive system, mm-hmm, is trying to extract the liquids, mm-hmm, that are in a sense contained. So the fiber, what's coming out here on the side, mm-hmm, is simply the vehicle, mm-hmm, that houses the vitamins, the minerals. And so this is doing the same thing as when you start to chew and as you go through the digestive process. Now, okay, however, mm-hmm, there are certain things that you can do with the pulp that comes out. Mm-hmm. And when we get into some of the food preparation later on, because, mm-hmm, we'll be doing some live living raw gourmet food preparation.
Oh, yes.
These are some of the things that you can use to make pies, to make pizzas, to make lasagna, you know, etc. So it doesn't necessarily have to go to waste.
Okay.
So with that, we will have a chance to pull this away.
As wow. Imagine in a small jug, we had a tray full of vegetables, and now this is about 2-3 glasses?
Yes, and we'll go ahead.
That's about 800. ML.
Yes, ML in that, mm-hmm, regards. And so, mm-hmm, with that, we're looking at approximately 1 liter of juice right there.
Mm-hmm.
Now, as you saw, there was a pretty much sizable amount of veggies there. If we were to try to eat all of those veggies at one sitting, mm-hmm, it'll be a little bit difficult.
Mm-hmm.
But we can have an opportunity, mm-hmm, to drink this probably in 30 seconds, mm-hmm, as we will be able to do that.
Mm-hmm.
And when we do that, we are able to take in all the minerals, all the vitamins, mm-hmm, all the wonderful
and
goodness.
And the color is beautiful. It's not as green. People are scared of green juices.
Yes. Well, the beautiful thing with Mother Nature, mm-hmm, is you can have an opportunity to bring all the colors of the rainbow.
Mm-hmm.
That's why we say back to nature.
Mm-hmm.
Colors come from nature.
Thank you.
All right. The closer we are to nature, the more whole, happy, at ease, at peace we are. The, mm-hmm, further we move away from nature, we get into dis-ease, which is the root word of
disease,
right?
Mm-hmm.
And so with that, this is our wonderful skin-glowing concoction,
mm-hmm,
that will be able to bring that suppleness, mm-hmm, back to our skin.
So
let's see
to
how
as
it
as beautiful skin as a baby's bum. And trust me, it will be smooth everywhere. We are going to get high on juice today.
Mm.
Nice. I don't think anybody's going to struggle drinking this stuff.
Mm-mm.
Mm? It's so yummy. It's so nice. I probably should give to some of the camera people. They look like they haven't done this.
They're ready. Are they salivating yet?
And most of them are men. I'm sure they need some sorting out in some areas I can't mention today before they make me look, you know.
Fantastic. So, mm-hmm, we'll go ahead and move this
is nice.
Over. Get a chance to move this.
Now, I see, Junga, with this, you really don't need to eat food. I remember when I was juicing for 7 days.
Yes.
Exclusively without eating any food.
Yes.
When I get hungry.
Yes.
Okay, I cheated a little with an extra juice.
Okay.
I didn't cheat with chicken.
Okay.
Which was still okay.
Yes.
So when I felt like I'm starving on the second day.
Yes.
I would actually make an extra juice.
Ah.
And the minute you drink the juice, you feel like your eyes have just opened up. You've just woken up and you have a lot of energy.
Yes. Mm-hmm. I'm feeling like I'm sort of on cloud nine right now.
Mm-hmm.
And it's very, very powerful. Now, it's important, ladies and gentlemen, everyone listening
this in the
here,
fridge?
And this is some, exactly, when you have leftovers, you can go ahead and put it in a particular mason jar.
Okay, how long does it stay in the fridge for
right,
it to continue?
We ask to keep it no longer than 24 hours in the fridge.
Hours.
Why? Because in here, mm-hmm, it's alive. This is living food. Mm-hmm. And it's very important that we put living food into our body because we are living. If we don't, we want to stay away from dead food.
Oh boy, okay. Processed. I don't want to go into that discussion with Puga because it's going to stop me from eating chicken. Because before I eat the chicken, I have to kill it. Let's not talk about that right now.
No. There's some of the processed food, some of the food that is unnatural. Mm-hmm. Too much artificial, mm-hmm. is dead food.
Okay.
This food is alive. And so in there you have enzymes. You have many things that are still living. Mm-hmm. And that's what we want to be able to put in the body. So we say you can store it in a fridge, mm-hmm. for about 24 hours. Mm-hmm. But after that, it sort of loses the power it has. Now, it might still taste good. Mm-hmm. You can still drink it. Mm-hmm. But it might not have as much of the oomph, mm-hmm. that we want. That comes.
Actually, I did experience the difference when I juice.
Yes.
Drop in some ice cubes and drink it. It's fresher and so tasty.
Absolutely.
And it's crisp.
Absolutely.
Okay, than when
absolutely.
You put it in the fridge and then you drink it the next day.
Yes, absolutely.
So don't make too much. Make just enough. Unless you're going somewhere, just make enough. And make sure wherever it is you're going, you have a fridge. And for me, I was using the flask cups.
The flask, exactly. Mm. Then those can keep, you know, in terms of... healthier longer. So
yes.
The next juice we'll go into, we'll have an opportunity to deal with. A lot of people have abdominal issues,
mm-hmm.
right? So whether it's, sometimes acid reflux, mm-hmm. Even getting to ulcers and things along those lines.
Mm-hmm.
And there's nothing more powerful, even when dealing with things like colitis.
Oh boy. Here we go with cabbage again. Okay.
This wonderful thing called cabbage. Yes, and they come in all wonderful colors. So as a matter of fact, in the background here, we have some of the red cabbage.
Which is even worse than this.
It's beautiful. And so I know Gertrude's one of her favorite ingredients is cabbage. So Gertrude...
No, it's not one of my favorite. I was given a challenge to take cabbage.
Yes.
My favorite is pineapple.
I know you love pineapple. And pineapple is something wonderful.
And not just that, because I care about my Miss Victoria.
Yes.
This makes Miss Victoria smell a little. Pineapple makes me feel smell good.
Okay.
So a combination of the two, I guess, is fine.
Oh, wonderful.
Who
okay.
wouldn't know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Anyway.
So you go ahead and chop.
So what am I supposed to do?
I'm going to ask you to chop that in half. You might want to, I don't know if the smaller knife, this one might be a little bit better.
Mm-hmm.
In the meantime, when you have a chance to do that, let me chop the ends off the carrots here.
Okay.
Sort of move that to the side for our carrots here today.
I don't have to do smaller pieces.
Yes, I'm going to ask you to. You're doing a perfect job there.
We can exchange juices after this.
Makes
life much easier.
This is a pretty decent juicer. Let's put it that way. Mm-hmm. Even the apples could actually go in whole,
mm-hmm.
but in this case, we'll go ahead and chop them in half, and then let me quickly have an opportunity to peel our citrus lemon fruit here.
Okay.
Now. With that, when we go ahead and bring Mother Nature into the body,
mm-hmm.
yes, we say people treat a lot of times their vehicles, their cars,
better than
their
bodies. As Kunga continues to peel the lime, we're going to take a short break. When we come back, we'll continue with this second recipe, which is good for your tummy. Kunga is going to explain more. I've always told you, what is good for your health is good for your Mombasa Raha. There's no separating the two. After this short break. Welcome back to Connect, a very special episode of Connect. Kunga is in the house. We are juicing our way to a happier Mombasa Raha life. At least I am. Kunga doesn't want to disclose that area, but it's fine. I care for you. This was good juice for your skin. And now we are juicing for our tummy.
Absolutely.
What did you say about our
absolutely.
Tummy?
Well, with that, I want to say Mother Nature is in the house.
Mm-hmm.
And we're definitely happy to be back here with you again, Gertrude. So a lot of people have a lot of abdominal tummy issues.
Is it
so
something like ulcers?
It could be as extreme as ulcers. Mm-hmm. This could be upset stomach. It could be acid reflux.
Constipation.
There's several. Constipation.
Uh-huh.
So a lot of issues go on in tummy. So this is a relatively simple
mm-hmm.
Recipe because it has one of the most powerful ingredients, which is the particular cabbages that we're including in it. So let's go ahead.
Of course, I love cabbage so much. I'm only going to take 2 pieces.
Okay.
Only
there
2 pieces.
We go. So we're going to turn this on here.
Okay.
And with that, we'll...
We didn't remove anything, just putting the whole thing.
Yes.
Yeah.
As long as you have it powerful enough.
Okay.
Juicer. Mm-hmm. Oh. Okay.
Oh, are you pouring?
There we go. By the way, you can see that when we're juicing, things are not always perfect.
Yeah.
And
accidents happen.
And you can say that, in a sense... You're able to deal with things when it may go wrong. All right,
okay.
So let's go ahead and finish up with that particular cabbage.
So most of it.
Let's go ahead and put that in. There we go. Okay. We're going to put our carrots in there. Okay.
And the apples.
Have the better carotene. It's very powerful. Obviously, the ginger gives that punch. Ginger is one of the most powerful antibiotics as well, along with garlic. Very powerful. Lime. Let's put in our apples. Sort of gives a little sweet there. And then, of course, our lime, which allows us to have an opportunity to bring in that alkalinity to the body. So we'll take this out, open up our top there. Mm-hmm. No one ever said that juicing is a unmessy affair. Mm-hmm. So don't be scared to get a little bit of juices all over the place as you get a chance to make your different wonderful concoctions. What's important is what's going into the body. Okay. So, with that being said there.
All right. So, this is what I'm going to do.
Yes.
I'm going to put a little for me here.
That's...
and leave the rest for my producer, Grace. I mean, she needs cabbage, I think, a lot more than me.
Wonderful. So, with that, we'll go ahead and take our abdominal.
Don't smell. Just drink it.
Mmm. Mmm.
It's kind of nice. Cabbage-ish, but nice.
Cabbage, you taste the ginger flavor, you taste
the lime,
the apples, and the carrots. Yes. But you know, cabbage juice actually, it has a wonderful taste. So don't give Mother Nature in the form of cabbages a bad name, okay?
Okay, so this is for Grace. I'm going to keep it right here.
So let's put that over to the side. Mm-hmm. Let's move this tray on over. And let's deal with our...
juice. I was looking forward to this.
So this one, obviously you can see, mm-hmm. is full of color. Mm-hmm. This one, as you can see, has a lot of chlorophyll. And as we learned in school, mm-hmm. the chlorophyll comes from a process called photosynthesis. Mm-hmm. So what happens, Mother Nature is so powerful that the sun that we know that all the planets rotate around, mm-hmm. what happens, the plants capture the sun, mm-hmm. and it produces this green color. And in this green color, when we bring in the chlorophyll, mm-hmm. it has all the enzymes, all the antioxidants. It brings life into our body. Mm-hmm. So with that, I'm going to ask you to go ahead and peel mm-hmm. those particular zucchini. So we're going to have two zucchinis.
Zucchini.
And this one primarily helps to deal with our blood sugar. Mm-hmm. And as you know, a lot of people are affected by diabetes, type 1, type 2 diabetes. Mm-hmm. Others are pre-diabetic. Like myself, I was on that borderline. So with that, we're going to have, actually, I'm going to ask you to peel, if you don't mind, before the skin off of. As you peel, I'm going to go ahead and open up another carrot on this end here. And the zucchinis are relatively easy to peel. And the ingredients that we have here today are the particular spinach, one apple, two zucchinis.
Give me that one here. Peeling the zucchini, aka courgette, aka baby marrow, it's because we're not sure if it's organic.
That's right.
If you're 100% sure, we'll just blend it all.
There we go.
Yeah. Because even the peel has some nutrients.
Has great nutrients mm-hmm. in it, but we just want to err on the side of caution. And then, of course, we have the wonderful dania, mm-hmm. the wonderful
cilantro.
Cilantro, coriander, known by different names, which is going to give it a wonderful aroma. Mm-hmm. So let's go ahead, turn our juicer on today, make sure everything is in place there. And what we can start is let us start with the spinach. Why? Because it doesn't produce as much juice, and so we want to make sure we can put the ones that are more liquefied in after. So we'll put the whole spinach in there, okay? And go ahead and push it down. See the beautiful green color that comes from that? And let's just make sure that goes in.
Okay,
we can go ahead, and the apples can be put in either half or whole, depending on the size of the juicer that you have. Get a chance to put the apples through. We're gonna put in this whole bunch of wonderful cilantro, wonderful dania, and then we close it out with our particular zucchini. Okay? So with that being said, it gets a chance to clear out there. Fantastic. We're gonna turn our juicer off. We're going to bring our two.
Honestly, Kunga, I've never taken a green juice without ginger, without lime.
Well, guess what?
So
there's a first time for everything.
Yes.
There was a time you had never gone to Mombasa Raha.
For me? That was a long time ago. A very long time ago.
Well, good. So with this, you're going to sort of pop the cherry mm-hmm. of this green juice. As you see, it looks wonderful. It smells wonderful. The dania gives it that extra flavor. And it's so full of such...
Well, I wouldn't say the smell is very orgasmic today, but it smells good.
Well, it adds a different variation.
Okay.
That's the beauty of Mother Nature.
Again, I'm a generous woman. I'm going to put a little for myself, yes. then keep the rest for Eugene. Eugene is one of the camera people. He needs this.
Yeah, by the way, it's nothing wrong with trying different items, mm-hmm. seeing different combinations. Now, these ones are certain recommended recipes for certain ailments. However, there's nothing wrong with maybe throwing in some extra basil there, mm-hmm. or putting in a piece of onion, or getting a chance to try a beet. Beets are wonderful. Mm-hmm. It gives that red, beautiful red color. Mm-hmm. And sometimes you can even cut an avocado in half. Once you've made the juice, mm-hmm. put the avocado in the blender, because you cannot juice an avocado.
Or
bananas. You cut them in, there you go, put them in the blender, and then pour your juice in the blender after you've juiced and get a chance to add extra. So you can do, even matter of fact, tomatoes. We have a wonderful juice that I'm sure many Kenyans will be aware of and love, mm-hmm. called kachumbari.
I remember juice. That when I was juicing.
Right? And so in that regards, mm-hmm. You can use the tomatoes and the onions and the pili pili, etc.
You know what I used to do with kachumbari?
What?
For me, when I was juicing, I used to crave for something hot. Mm. And because I had not discovered the herbal teas, mm. I would just juice my kachumbari, then heat it up a little.
So it can be a bit warm. Just warm it. Okay, almost tasty. Like a soup a little bit.
Yes.
Fantastic. Mm. Well, with that, let's say without, don't take me away from drinking this green. We're going to drink this green one now.
Yes,
so let's go ahead and throw it out and get a chance to taste, because this is the prize for all the hard work putting it together.
If you have diabetes, you are on insulin, and next time we're going to have another episode where people give testimonies on juices and their illnesses. Not bad.
Yes.
It tastes a lot of dania.
The dania is there strong, but it has the spinach in there. Mm-hmm. It has the courgettes in there in terms of the zucchini. Mm-hmm. And in that, it has the goodness of a greens. And greens, as a matter of fact, what we recommend, it's okay to have different color juices, mm-hmm. but what we try to do is recommend 80% greens, mm-hmm. and about 20% fruits. Okay. Why? The greens have the most powerful life in them. Mm-hmm. They're the ones that help to repair your body. Mm-hmm. If you went out and you were partying on a Friday night, mm-hmm. you went out and you were partying on a Saturday night, you wake up with a hangover, mm-hmm. right? And your head is dizzy. If you go and get a piece of ginger, some garlic, some skumawiki, or like we put in some spinach, mm-hmm. gonna get a courgette, mm-hmm. in that regard, zucchini, mm-hmm. And then you drink it, what this does is neutralizes the toxicity, mm-hmm. in the body that leads to the hangovers, that leads to a lot of the diseases that people are suffering for. And that's the beauty of Mother Nature. Mm-hmm. She will take away the toxicity that accumulates in our body that leads us to not living an optimal life. And so with that, I just want to say thank you and the Mombasa Raha family so much for having this demonstration here, mm-hmm. with us today, because the last time we talked, mm-hmm. right? And we want to do more than just talking. We want to apply and show how easy it is.
This is just about the juices. Today, we didn't talk about the supplements. Remember in the other episode when Shkunga came on TV, on Connect, we talked about the flax seed, we talked about the chia seeds,
yes.
the moringa. We will do another episode where you incorporate the juices with the supplements.
The supplements.
The Mother Nature supplements.
Yes, and the complement. Because what we say, when you do take your body occasionally for servicing, mm-hmm. the way you take your car for servicing, mm-hmm. we say, yes, you're going to drink only liquids and juices, mm-hmm. but we say complement it with other liquids, such as madafu coconut water, herbal teas, sugarcane juice, even nut milks, but we say complement, mm-hmm. with things like moringa, spirulina, flaxseed, chia seed that you ground, as well as a cayenne, mm-hmm. so that you make sure your body is getting all the nutrients it needs. Mm-hmm. And at no point in time when you service your body for 3, 7, 24 days, mm-hmm. do you ever get to a place where you're starving. Mm-hmm. Your body has been given all the nutrients that it needs. Mm-hmm. And as a matter of fact, any time that you might have a little uncomfortableness, that's just your body going through withdrawal symptoms.
Okay.
So with that, we can be here forever and ever talking about the wonders of Mother Nature. And so thank you for having us today.
Thank you, Kunga. So this was a cabbage juice and this was a spinach juice. So this is for Grace and this is for Eugene. We are done. I can't imagine. I hope you have learned from this. You don't need to I mean, really, if you start juicing, your medical bills go down, your Mombasara life goes up, and I'm not even talking about the multiple big O story for another day, because this is a Thursday episode. Kunga, thank you.
Thank you.
I'll be calling you again.
Fantastic.
Because this is barely everything Kunga does. He hasn't even shared his full testimony yet. He did 100 days of juices, exclusive juicy with no solids. Thank you so much. See you next time. Again, another episode of Back to Nature. What's good for your life is good for your Mombasara.